For this one, we're going to take a look at the quickest way to remove a background from our image using a one-click selection. If you don't already have an image, you can go to File and Open. Now that we've got ourselves an image, what you want to do is you want to hold Alt and scroll up to zoom into the image. To get to the tool, you want to go down to the fourth tool down, and this is the Object Selection tool. If you right-click on it, it will be in here, so it'll be together with the Quick Selection tool and the Magic Wand. If you don't see it straight away, then you can just right-click on it and it should be in there. Once you've got the Object Selection tool selected, you'll need to know a few things before you actually use it. So if you don't know these tools, then I will quickly go over them. So you'll have the first one. The first one is a single selection, which means you can only have a singular selection. You cannot edit it, you cannot subtract or do anything with it. So that is the first one. The second one is all about adding on to the current selection. So if you wanted to, you can add more, or you could take away, or you could keep on editing the selection as many times as you want. The third option is all about subtract, so it's all about taking away. If you wanted to, you can take away from the selection just by going around the areas that you don't want or you want to remove from your selection. And the very last one is all about a custom shape inside of the image that you have. So if you wanted to, you can create yourself a box, and that will only select the areas inside of that box. And it will get rid of all the other selections, and it will only keep that box. So with the modes, you have rectangular and a manual lasso tool. With the rectangular tool, this will allow you to create a box around the object that you want it to select. And then, of course, the lasso tool is all about freehand selection. So you can pretty much go around the selection you want it to select. We're going to use the rectangular one. And then moving on to the next options that you have available. This is completely up to you. If you wanted to, you can turn on auto enhance. Or you can have Object Subtract, which is the one I use. I like to use the Object Subtract because it allows me to quickly swap over between plus and minus. And finally, we have two more buttons at the end. So the first one is Select Subject. This is a one-click selection. If you click this, the computer will pretty much try to guess what the object is that you wanted to select. So with the rectangular mode, let's say you had multiple people in your image, or you have more people or objects that you want to select. All you got to do with the object selection one is left click and drag yourself a box around the object. And this will pretty much detect what it is that you are trying to select. So just like the quick selection tool, it may not be as accurate and it may not get every single bit in. And this is when we can pretty much edit the selection. Now, like I mentioned before, the object selection tool is tied in with the quick selection tool and the magic wand. So if we wanted to, we can quickly switch over to the quick selection tool and then turn this into a minus and then take away from here. Or we can add onto it. So if we wanted to, include it into the image. So as you can see, we've just added it back on. If you wanted to, you can also go to the polygonal lasso tool, and that one will let you edit it as well. At the moment, the glasses aren't in it, but I'm not too fussed about that because I will fix that once we start to edit it a little bit more. Once you've selected most of your image or the object that you wanted to select, all you got to do is you got to go to Select and Mask. This option will only appear if you are in the selection options. So if you're in the Select or the Object Selection tool. If you're in other tools, it won't appear, so you need to make sure you are selecting the object selection tool. Once you've selected it, you go to Select and Mask, and this will bring you to this window right here. Things are a little bit more different now. You will have some options. Yours will be on the right side, but I've moved mine over to the left side, so it's easier to see. We're going to get ourselves the Refine Edge tool, and then we're going to fix up the hair. So as you can see, the hair isn't looking so good at the moment. It is quite rushed. So what we're going to do is you can increase the size by pressing the square bracket on your keyboard. And then we're going to go around the hair like so. And as you can see, it's already starting to remove the white areas. It will also bring back any other hair. So as you can see, when we get to this hair down here, it will bring it back into the image. And there we go. That's not looking too bad. If you wanted to, you can show edges only. So this will preview the edges. So this is what we've done. So what we're going to do now is we're going to edit this a little bit more. And we're going to untick this. And then get rid of the glasses right here. Now, the reason I've done it like this is because I could have gotten rid of it before. But as you can see, we've still got a little bit of a fog effect onto it. So I did remove it, but because I refined it, it looks a lot better than if we was to fully remove it. So that's not looking too bad at the moment. I'm going to fix the forehead a little bit as well, right there. It's looking a bit rough. So as you can see, it's already started to make it smoother and a little bit there as well. We are also going to go around the beard and the bits around there, like so. Go around it. You can also apply it to the top. It'll give it that effect of a jumper or sweater, whichever one you prefer to call it. So that's not looking too bad at the moment. We can once again show the edges. We're also going to do it here as well. And yeah, so far it's looking not too bad. We can also preview what it would look like originally. So as you can see, before, and then this is after. A lot better than before. You can also have high quality preview if you wanted to. You can turn down the opacity. You can also change the color if you wanted to. So for example, if we want the background color to be, let's say, blue, or we can have it as a white dark color, you can have it whatever you would prefer. You could change it in here. You have some other options as well. So you have the radius, smooth, feather, contrast, soft edge, or swift edge, so I say, my bad. What these options do is these will determine whether you want to sharpen your edges. So for example, if you had some rough edges, you can get yourself a radius of how much you want it to apply. You can get yourself how much you want it to smoothen out the edges. You can give it a little bit of a feather, so you can pretty much play about with the feather and the sharpness to achieve what you are looking for. And then you also have contrast as well. At the moment, it's not looking too bad. I'm quite happy with what it looks like. I think there's a little bit down here that I missed, so I'm going to fix that up. As you can see, there's that little bit of a white area. To save this as a layer, all you got to do is go down to where it says Output To, and then I like to set it as a new layer. And then once you've set it as a new layer, you can then go ahead and press OK. And the background will pretty much be masked. So now it's completely gone. You'll still have your original one, as you can see underneath it, but your new one will be right there. So if I have a look at the bits that we've just removed, it's looking pretty good. Some edges may be a bit soft, so as you can see right here. But to fix this, all you got to do is press Ctrl J, and then this will get yourself another copy of it, and this will make it a little bit more solid around the edges, or the bits where you've done. So I'm quite happy with that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to merge these two together. So if you go to Convert Smart Object, and if you wanted to, you can rasterize as layer to put this back into a normal layer so you can edit it.